Australia has been offered a ringside seat at the hottest show on earth. ITER is the next step fusion device. ITER have invited us to install Australian technology. This is an opportunity for Australia to be a part of the next phase of the global clean energy revolution.
Our future is dependent on having clean, safe energy that can be utilised by the population as it grows and allows us to have the quality of life for as many people as possible on the planet. Fusion energy, the power of the sun, this is the solution. The sun works on fusion. That's smashing hydrogen atoms together to make a heavier atom and releasing a large amount of energy. The fusion energy of the sun brought to Earth would be a clean, safe, sustainable form of energy for our future.
Unlike the sun, we need to produce high pressures and high temperatures to produce plasma. ITER uses powerful magnetic fields shaped like a donut to hold the plasma inside the machine called a tokamak. We also have a very wide range of plasma measurement systems, which we call diagnostics, and these are used to measure plasma parameters like temperature, density, in order to control the plasma, the intense environment in which the fusion reactions occur.
To build this device that has to have temperatures much higher even than the sun, you have to have the best materials and you have to know what's going on in that machine. And between ANU, who have got the diagnostic capability, and ANSTO with the materials capability, and a raft of universities across Australia, we have the opportunity to partner and participate in this great project that is happening in a global consortium.
I'm standing in front of the H1 Heliac. It's been the centerpiece of the Australian Fusion Research Facility for the last two decades. Based on the work we have done here over a number of decades, we have an invitation to join ITER and establish a new Australian fusion program there to measure temperatures in excess of 200 million degrees and supersonic flows in the heart of the fusion plasma. Essentially, we've developed a Doppler imaging camera which enables us to measure the temperature and the flow speeds in the edge of the plasma. There are no other competing technologies that can do this, and our instruments are now installed on frontline fusion devices all around the world.
I first started working with ANU around 10 years ago, and we now have a number of Australian-built cameras installed on machines both here in the UK and also with our collaborators at the Southwestern Institute of Physics in China.
Australia can make important contribution to the ITER project, in particular in the delivery of the advanced Doppler imaging system.
ITER organization and ANSTO signed an agreement last year to allow Australian scientists to come and participate in the multi-billion dollar ITER project. We have reserved prime port space on ITER for a Doppler coherence imaging system. Because coherence imaging is an Australian invention, Australia would be the best place to develop a system for the ITER tokamak.
The cost to develop and deploy a Doppler imaging camera on ITER and to establish a future fusion program for Australia on this device is around $30 million over 10 years. Of that, a large fraction will flow back into Australian industry and enterprise supporting the development of the program. ITER itself has committed to funding up to 15% of the total costs of the Australian contribution. For a small investment, Australia can leverage the multi-billion dollar global program that is ITER. It's an opportunity to keep us prepared for the coming age of fusion, an inspiration for our next generation of scientists and engineers. It's an opportunity that we can't afford to miss.
Please come and join us in the world's largest research energy project.